Hello, my name is Riley Winkler, and I'm the product marketer representing ArcGIS Enterprise. Along with my colleague John Emch from Technical Support, I'm here to talk about the new and exciting features coming to ArcGIS Enterprise 11.3. In this long-term support release of ArcGIS Enterprise, we are highlighting new features and improved functionalities such as updates to the Living Atlas, new field types, custom web tools in Map Viewer, and more. So with that, I'll turn it over to John to explain some of the highlights of this release.
Thank you, Riley, for the introduction. One of our most exciting features of ArcGIS Enterprise 11.3 is the ability to update Living Atlas content. Prior to this release, ArcGIS Enterprise would include access to a subset of Living Atlas specific to that ArcGIS Enterprise version. This proved somewhat challenging as we continually update and add new Living Atlas content. If using ArcGIS Enterprise, you could only gain access by upgrading your ArcGIS Enterprise deployment. With the release of ArcGIS Enterprise 11.3, we've introduced the ability for administrators to update Living Atlas content regularly without needing to upgrade ArcGIS Enterprise. To do this, log into ArcGIS Enterprise as an administrator. Access Organization Settings, and select Living Atlas. With Living Atlas content enabled, we can scroll down the page and note the new content version window. This pane shows us the current version of Living Atlas content, along with its installation date. It also includes the option to download and install content once it becomes available. These updates will be made available regularly by Esri. Now, you'll be able to take advantage of new content without needing to upgrade ArcGIS Enterprise. In ArcGIS Enterprise 11.3, we have new field types. The new field types are big integer, date only, time only, and timestamp offset. Prior to this, time and date fields always had a specific time and date associated with them. This works for most data, but think of something like birthdays. There's no need to specify the time you were born in, or even to have to consider what time zone. These new field types seek to make working with date and time easier across ArcGIS Enterprise in these unique instances, paying special attention to differentiating between time zones of data collection. The Map Viewer in ArcGIS Enterprise 11.3 includes updates you may have seen in the ArcGIS Online October 2023 and February 2024 updates. In this release, sketch layers will support important functions like duplicating sketch features within a sketch, utilizing improved tooltip functionality to show feature dimensions, adding titles and pop-ups to multiple sketch features, and copying sketch features between different sketch layers. Another important update deals with the display order of pop-ups. Features from multiple layers will now display in the same order that they are displayed on the map, eliminating any inconsistencies in the pop-up order. Last but not least, something unique to ArcGIS Enterprise 11.3. If you published custom web tools from models, scripts, or notebooks, these will be available in the Map Viewer Analysis pane. Previously, these had to be run in a separate web application. This improvement makes it that much easier to use your web tools right alongside your data in Map Viewer. To keep ArcGIS Enterprise at the cutting edge of software improvements, .NET 8 is now required for the Microsoft IIS Web Adapter, along with the .NET-based Server Object Extensions, SOEs, and Server Object Interceptors, SOIs. This is just something to keep in mind as you upgrade ArcGIS Enterprise.
Thank you for joining us in exploring the latest updates coming to ArcGIS Enterprise 11.3. We hope you found this video helpful. Stay tuned for more exciting content, and until then, goodbye.